We have seen value analysis and value engineering, which can be applicable for a process or a product. So here in your case, it is going to be the process. So here, as you said, it's going to be the value analysis rather than value engineering. So value engineering is the one where we apply the value methodology for the new process. So when you are applying the value engineering for a new process, you have very good savings, basically, since you are going to start the implementation of value engineering from the concept stage itself. But when you go for a value analysis, now you need to do some validation, you need to do some changes, especially for a process. Okay, so the potential savings is slightly going to be lesser than the value engineering. But again, you have always a scope for the cost reduction and value improvement, respective of value analysis or value engineering. So basically, this value methodology is going to have three stages.
Sir, previous slide, once again, just go back. Sir,
sir, could you please explain it again?
Just once again, sir. Just actually, this net saving, this is parallel activity, sir. Total cost of value engineering implemented. Okay, for value engineering implementation, we are talking here. And sir, so this cost will increase and ultimate savings will decrease, right?
Yeah. Because even to implement value engineering, what you have to do is you have to have some costs for testing, and for to prove your ideas you need to have some cost. So the cost is going to be higher if you delay the time, basically. But if you involve the value engineering right from the start of the process, then the validation of those process costs is going to be lesser. Basically, this is for a product, starts with concept, design modification, engineering, change, release, production. But for a process, also this can be applicable, where you're also going to design the process or the facilities. So you always look for the thing like, whenever you go for a new setup of a manufacturing plant or a new process, then this can be applicable there as well. But when I say value analysis, it is going to be completely the one which is already been existing, which is basically a production one, already in production. So your process is already in production. Again, you need to see whatever ideas you are going to give, you need to validate it, you need to test it, for which some of the cost is required, right? Those costs will be higher than the cost what would have been there initially when you have done the same ideas, same implementation 3 years or 4 years back before you start before you would have started the process. Okay. It's always better to look at any cost reduction proposals during the start of a project or a process, which put in more savings rather than looking at after implementation or after production.
Yeah, sir. In our case, I think this production, it will be like this graph is applicable for us.
Yes.
Block.
Yeah.
Okay.
And this again, still, this graph is something. It is not applicable. See here, what I would have mentioned is beyond this point, value means when you implement the value engineering, it is going to be the loss, right? But it is not a case to be like that. But say for example, now we are in 2021. So if you delay the number of years, if you do the same process after 3 years or 4 years, you are going to delay it by another 3 years or 4 years, which means again, there can be some net loss is going to happen than the one what you are going to implement now. So the more you delay, the savings is going to, because it's not that you are going to delay 3 years alone. You are going to delay. You are going to the 3 year savings that gets accumulated here, right? So 3 year savings is going to be the loss for you when you are not going to implement it right away, rather than going to implement after 2024. Okay, this 3 years is not going to be just a saving alone. So saving is not a loss for you. Sorry, the loss is going to be the loss what you are going to get in terms of not saving the process cost. Okay, that is the net loss for you. So higher the time you take, it is again going to be risky, which means risky in the sense you are going to lose the savings basically, which means you are going to have the same cost which you are going to give it, you are going to ask your customer to pay for you. And again, your customer is going to pay for a higher cost, which is not necessary because you are not going to compromise on the profit. You are going to sell your end output to your customer, maybe 8 to 15% profit. So now what is in your hand is with the same profit, what you can achieve is you can reduce their overall manufacturing cost or selling cost. Okay. In that way, if you reduce the selling cost, and again your customer will also be happy, and again they will also get. In fact, they will also sell it to their customer with lesser cost. So in fact, there is a possibility that your number of orders can also get higher if you reduce the number of the selling cost. So it is directly going to you have the strategy with respect to your business point of view, wherein you can look for improving the profit and also the strategy of your business as well.
Okay, sir.
And this is basically for a product graph. Like, say for example, if you have less volumes, say for example, especially when you go for a product, like there are a lot of ways to reduce the cost for a product by changing the material, by changing the suppliers, and then sourcing activities and design change. So when you change your design, say for example, when you are reducing the material, when you are reducing the thickness of the material from 4 mm to 2 mm, you need to do some testing, for which you need to have testing cost. And then if you're changing the material from aluminum to plastic, you need to do some validation testing. So if you would have done the change at the start of the project itself, then the thickness 4 mm to 2 mm would have been considered here. Then the testing costs would have been lesser. But when you do after production, what happens? The cost to implement it is going to be higher. Okay, because you need to do a lot of changes with respect to the tooling. So a lot of things will be involved here when you do the modification after production. But again, if the volume is going to be higher, then obviously the profit is going to be there. But again, especially for products like automobile products, where the volumes is going to be very huge. Okay. See, for you, you are going to give, your end customer is going to be Tata Steel, right? If I'm not wrong, your customer is going to be Tata Steel, right?
Tata Steel, JSW.
Yeah. This Tata Steel JSW is also giving the product to automobiles, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and in fact, the volumes of automobile is going to be very huge. So when you reduce the cost, your customer is going to reduce cost. In fact, when your customer is going to reduce the cost, the automobile manufacturer is going to reduce the cost. When they reduce the cost, the end customer who is going to buy the car or a vehicle or the automobile things, they are going to get benefited. And again, you know, nowadays there is a big problem with respect to the price increase of the steel, raw material price increase. So again, there are a lot of challenges is there. Considering that, see, the volumes is going to be higher, especially for your end product. Okay, so when your volume is going to be higher, obviously it is a very high time that you need to look for value improvement, value methodology implementation, and how this can be benefiting not only to your immediate customer, not only just to your immediate customer, but to your end user basically. Means who is going to use your product. It's not just your Tata Steel or JSW alone, or that is going, in fact, going to OEMs like Mahindra, Tata Motors, Horse Motors, or Maruti, Hyundai, whatever it is. And in fact, finally, that is going to the common public. Okay. So in fact, that is complete supply chain management. Okay. So that's how you also need to look into it. And in that way, you can also have the business case as well.
Sir, so in our case, so what we will consider is with respect to volume and with respect to potential savings,
exactly.
We can select the projects, right, sir?
Exactly. Yes. Yeah.